Starting from the original Resident Evil in 1996, the long-running series has featured plenty of unlockable alternate costumes for characters in many of their games. Today, we're going to attempt to take a look at the complete history of every alternate costume in the horror series. Resident Evil, the classic story of the Raccoon City Police Department's STARS division, allowed players to choose between playing as either Jill Valentine or Chris Redfield. If the player wins the game with the best ending, they unlock a key to a closet where alternate costumes from the usual STARS uniforms can be chosen. These outfits varied between which console you were playing on, and included some casual outfits for both of them with plenty of 90s style, a brave bomber jacket for Chris that is likely referencing his history in the Air Force, and alternate STARS uniforms with different colorations. One thing to note is that Chris's casual outfit features a jacket with a Made in Heaven logo, which is a reference to the Queen song of the same name. There are a variety of small Queen references throughout the Resident Evil games, but Made in Heaven is the most frequently recurring, and we'll even be seeing more of it later in the video. The 1997 director's cut of the game also had alternate STARS uniforms that were a bit more unique in style from the previous ones, and also included one for the character Rebecca this time around. In 2006, there was an updated version of Resident Evil released on Nintendo DS titled Deadly Silence, which had different alternate costumes than the original release. Jill, Rebecca, and Chris each got a more humorous and fan service style for their alternate costumes this time around, from a tiny police uniform to a cheerleader costume to Ninja Chris. They definitely just feel like fun Halloween costumes, besides the obvious police connection and the Capcom logo on Rebecca's uniform, so it's kind of fun. In 1998, with Resident Evil 2, starring Leon Kennedy and Claire Redfield, alternate costumes were unlocked in a more complicated way than simply winning the game. But if done correctly, Leon could wear either a leather jacket with a skull emblem or a tank top and RPD cap instead of his normal police uniform. Claire had only one alternate costume instead of two, a leather jacket with flames and a Let Me Live logo, inspired by, again, the Queen song of the same name. And this game also includes the previous Queen reference. Claire's regular outfit for the game has a vest with the Made in Heaven logo, just like her brother's alternate jacket in the first game. The Nintendo 64 Resident Evil 2 had different alternate costumes than other consoles. For Leon, this included a biker look complete with sunglasses and a bandana, and a STARS uniform. Claire only had one costume again, a strappy purple outfit, perhaps also somewhat biker-inspired, with the logo of the N64 version's developer on the back. 1999's Resident Evil 3 Nemesis featured a whopping 8 alternate costumes for its starring character, Jill Valentine, though again, the access to these costumes depend on which console you play on. Instead of the classic tube top and skirt Jill wears while escaping Raccoon City, players could change into her previous STARS uniform, a different police uniform, a leather biker suit, and two costumes inspired by other media. The first, a disco outfit a la Saturday Night Fever, and the second outfit based on the character Regina from Dino Crisis, a different 1999 Capcom game, complete with the red hair. Bonus costumes on the PC and Sega Dreamcast versions included more casual looks similar to the default outfit, from just changing up the shirt and colors to an even more different blouse look with pants. In 2000, Resident Evil Code Veronica's extra battle game mode featured a variety of unlockables for completing the minigame in different ways. Though these were mainly different characters you could play as aside from the regular Chris and Claire Redfield, one was an alternate costume for Claire. As a twist, it's based on the evil Umbrella Corporation's colors, and it's a sporty look paired with go-go boots and sunglasses. When you play as her, the ending screen shows her holding the classic red and white umbrella of their logo. One final note for Code Veronica before we go on to the next game is that remember that Let Me Live logo on Claire's alternate Resident Evil 2 costume? That returned for her normal costume in this game. Moving on to 2002, Capcom published its remake of the original Resident Evil game just 6 years after its first release. Jill got her classic Nemesis look and an army outfit, likely a nod to her character's previous military work. Chris's casual costume is a sort of skater look with a beanie and sunglasses, and it brought back that classic alternate costume Made in Heaven logo. His second unlockable outfit was taken from his uniform in Code Veronica. Rebecca also had an alternate costume, a cowgirl outfit that certainly stands out as not fitting in with the rest, although concept art shows that Jill could have also had a Western outfit. Or this crazy ensemble that likely inspired her look later on in Resident Evil 5. We're seeing that alternate outfits really helped to inspire some later default ones, huh? In 2015, the remaster of the remake added the BSAA uniforms from the Resident Evil 5 era of games for Chris and Jill. Also in 2002, Resident Evil 0 was released. It included some costumes for its heroes Rebecca Chambers and Billy Cohen. Aside from Rebecca's cowgirl outfit that returned from the last game, she received a leather outfit with detached sleeves, and Billy just got one alternate look called Jacket, a sort of flashy gangster look, perhaps inspired by his criminal character. There was also a remaster of Resident Evil 0 in 2016, which added lots of new alternate outfits. This included Rebecca's original design and original alternate design, and brought back her cheerleader look as well. There was a sports uniform inspired by her being on the RPD basketball team, and a different Stars uniform with a beret. Finally, there was a Team Wesker costume unlocked through his mode in the game, a feminized version of Albert Wesker's outfit with a nod to the red P30 injector from Resident Evil 5 on the front. Billy, on the other hand, got Wolf Force, inspired by uniforms in Capcom's game titled Mercs, and a blue-striped prisoner uniform, obviously again inspired by his escaped convict story, but also the character Cody from Capcom's Street Fighter series. Resident Evil actually held a t-shirt design contest, where fans could submit designs for others to vote on, and the winners would become DLC costumes for Rebecca. The winners were a cartoon zombie, Nurse Rebecca, and the Jill sandwich meme. Additionally, there were some Japanese-exclusive t-shirts for Rebecca that you can see here, based on different brands or just Resident Evil 0. In 2003, Resident Evil Outbreak was released, and with its multiplayer capabilities, there were plenty of characters to have alternate costumes. Kevin got the six-shooter cowboy look, Mark had casual wear, Jim had the slam dunk basketball jersey, George had outdoor expert, and David had the sleek club scene outfit. The female characters each got two outfits, Alyssa with the sporty street scene and the midnight collar dress, Yoko with the simple spring fashion and the gym class uniform, and Cindy with her on vacation and funny bunny costumes. The sequel, Outbreak File Number 2, came out in 2005, and it added a few new costumes in addition to some of the old ones, like a jacket and plaid shirt for Kevin, cycling gear for Jim, and then just shirtless David. Then there's a military uniform for Mark, because he's a veteran, and a surgeon look for George, because he's a surgeon. The girls each got a swimwear look, as well as a karate uniform for Alyssa, a kung fu uniform for Yoko, and a black ensemble for Cindy. 2005 also brought the fan-favorite game Resident Evil 4, which featured unlockable costume sets, where the playable characters Leon Kennedy and Ashley Graham would simultaneously have outfit changes. If you chose Leon's RPD uniform, Ashley gets a glitzy white ensemble, and this set actually changes the character Ada's outfit as well into the tactical gear she wears in one of 4's minigames. The second costume set gives Leon a very noir gangster look with a fedora and long scarf, and here Ashley gets a full suit of armor, surprisingly enough, and this costume actually has a use. If you choose this costume set, Ashley becomes invincible to enemies. 2009 gave us Resident Evil 5, where meeting different qualifications would unlock alternate costumes for Chris Redfield and Sheva Olimar. Chris got the camouflaged, almost zebra print safari costume, and a Stars uniform once again inspired by his look in Code Veronica. Sheva got the gold lame clubbin' look, complete with blonde hair, alongside the rather cliché, even racist, some say, tribal outfit. Through DLC or buying the gold edition of the game, you could also get the tank-like heavy metal costume for Chris, and an edgy shirtless look with the warrior costume. Sheva gets the business costume, likely inspired by the character Ingrid Hannigan from Resident Evil 4, and the Red Riding Hood-inspired fairy tale outfit. Also in 2009, the spin-off title Resident Evil The Darkside Chronicles offered unlockable costume for its many characters. And since there are a lot, I'll skip the ones simply based on what the characters had worn in previous games, only saying the new ones. Similar to the bonus outfits in Resident Evil 2, Leon and Claire both got biker looks, Leon with a star emblem instead of a skull this time, and the emblem on Claire's jacket is similar to the Made in Heaven bomber lady, but without the words. Chris, Claire, and Steve all got matching Western outfits, and Leon and Krauser got matching detective outfits, which I'm guessing might be based on some bit of pop culture I'm unfamiliar with, since they don't look particularly detective-like. So if you know, I'd love to hear it, but maybe it's just a random name. In 2011, Resident Evil released an entire game based on its previous Mercenaries minigames, and each character got one extra costume. Chris had Pilot, again likely inspired by his Air Force experience. Jill had Casual, obviously based on her clothing in Nemesis. Rebecca had a frilly nurse costume based on her role as a medic in Stars. Claire had a suit look inspired by the character Hannigan. Hunk's Mr. Death costume is Grim Reaper inspired, and Wesker's costume was Ouroboros, obviously based on his monstrous transformation in Resident Evil 5. Barry had Patriotic, a Stars and Stripes version of Chris's previous warrior costume, and similarly, Krauser had a heavy metal costume like Chris's, although with his signature beret. Moving on to 2012 with Resident Evil Revelations, the main characters were once again Jill Valentine and Chris Redfield, and of course, they got some alternate costumes. And sticking with the aquatic theme from parts of the game, we have Jill's pirate costume, complete with a parrot, and Chris's pin-up-like sailor costume. The character Keith got a ninja costume, which doesn't quite fit that aquatic theme, but he wasn't the only one to stick out. Hunk had Lady Hunk, a female version of the character. The main cast of the non-canon game Resident Evil Operation Raccoon City from 2012 all got one alternate DLC costume, which were all just a recolor of their normal outfit. Here are two examples, with Beltway just going gold and Bertha going red. So it's the same for all of them, just a different recolor. But the biggest game in the series from 2012 was, of course, Resident Evil 6. For the Mercenaries mode in this game, every main character got an alternate look. You got Pirate Leon with a crow, some sort of preppy cop for Helena, Samurai Chris, race car driver Piers, a sort of hip-hop inspired look for Jake, and a schoolgirl costume for Sherry based on her appearance as a child back in Resident Evil 2, and finally a Qipao dress for Ada. Each of these also had an alternately colored version. In addition to these costumes, there were also my favorite type of alternate looks in games, low-poly versions of each of them, harkening back to the style of the old 90s games. Revelations 2 was released in 2015, and the four main characters of the game each got costumes, unlocked either through DLC or achievements. Natalia Korda got the Lottie suit, which was based on her own teddy bear's clothing. Moira Burton got the Urban Ninja outfit, a hooded look with horns. Claire Redfield got Classic, based on her appearance in Resident Evil 2, particularly Darkside Chronicles' interpretation of that outfit. Sniper, a pretty casual look with some tactical gear. And Rodeo, a more modern and yet more revealing take on the cowboy costumes from previous games. Barry Burton got a Classic costume based on his appearance in the original Resident Evil, alongside the double-breasted military uniform-like Commandant outfit. Additional outfits for Claire and Barry, new uniforms for Terra Save and the BSAA, were Japanese exclusives that could only be unlocked through buying clothing items that these costumes were based upon. A pretty interesting real-life tie-in. 2019 brought the remake of Resident Evil 2. Leon and Claire got updated looks and updated alternate costumes. Leon got his classic Resident Evil 2 police uniform alongside a sheriff uniform based on the character Daniel Cortini in the game. Meanwhile, Claire got an updated take on her original vest and a military look with a Made in Heaven tattoo. She also had the Elsa Walker outfit based on the motorcycle racing character design that was redeveloped into Claire for Resident Evil 2, a cool nod to the series past. Leon and Claire also got matching noir costumes like classic detectives, slicking back Leon's hair and giving Claire a trilby hat. But the superior costume set for the duo might be the low poly versions based on their original looks, of course. Finally, we reached the last game so far to have alternate costumes, the remake of Resident Evil 3. All of the alternate DLC costumes in this game are based on the two main characters' previous designs, if you don't like their updated outfits. Jill gets her classic look for the game and her original Stars uniform from the first game, while Carlos just got the option to have his original hairstyle. Nothing too exciting for this game then, but the side game bundled with it, Resident Evil Resistance, offers alternate looks for the playable characters too. I won't go through all of them by name due to the large volume, but here's the general categories each character has. Grunge, Beach Breeze, Neon Nights, Urban Camouflage, Gold Outfits, Wasteland, Wrestler Costumes, Animal Mascots, and then one other unthemed alternate outfit with additional colors for everyone. Or they could all just wear Claire and Leon's outfits from the remake of 2. And there you have it. That's hopefully all of the alternate costumes Resident Evil games have had, from the first game in 1996 to their latest game remake from 2020, as complete a history I can hope to make. We've seen a lot of different outfits here today. Do you have a favorite or least favorite out of all these? I'd love to hear about it in the comments, and maybe I'll even comment my own. Thank you for watching. If you enjoyed it, don't forget to hit that like button or maybe even subscribe. And until next time, stay fashionable and stay groovy.